We get at the Cracker Jacks, but we blew all of our budget on yesterday's Chris Christie-style sweaters. We want to say congratulations to the four major leaguers who were elected to the Hall of Fame today. The first time that many players have been sent to Cooperstown in 60 years. Craig Biggio, Pedro Martinez, John Schmoltz, and Bird Slayer Randy Johnson, a tall fellow. But any talk of Hall of Famedom these days brings with it a side dish of steroids.
Steroids.
Not making it for the third year this time. Barry Bonds. And Roger Clemens. John, I know you love the Giants, but as for the Juicers, will they and should they ever be elected to Cooperstown?
Well, the Hall is very conflicted, the people who vote about what to do about the steroid era. There are people on the totally hardline position who say never, never, never.
Like
there's
me.
There's others who say, look, it was part of the time. There have been other crazy things, you know, the dead ball era, the Black Sox scandal, et cetera, et cetera. My view is that some of these, like Barry Bonds, if you took his statistics from the time he entered the league to 1998 when he started juicing, he would be a Hall of Fame candidate. If it were me voting, I'd vote him in. Clemens is the same way. Would have been a Hall of Famer even before he started juicing. There are some people who it's obvious. Guy like Mark McGwire, the juice was his whole thing.
Pure juice.
He would not be a famous player at all without having been on the juice.
Why send the message to kids and young players you can get in the Hall of Fame if you cheat, when there's no constitutional right to be in the Hall of Fame? Yeah, they had great careers before they juiced. Then they juiced. Let them live off their memories and write some books. They don't need to be in the Hall of Fame.
But part of the complexity is that we don't know exactly in this period that there was so much widespread performance enhancing drug taking.
Go look at the video.
Well, you can see some of them, but you can't tell. But you can't tell all of them. And so when you can't know what some of the pitchers, it's hard. You can't make a definitive determination. Frankly, I actually think steroids should be completely legalized and let juice loose throughout the NBA, the MLB. If it were up to me.